All right. Obviously, we're glad to be back in the flow of a actual, you know, last week having the bye week. It was important week for us. We were able to, you know, put a big emphasis on improvement in a lot of areas, our fundamentals, special teams, just across the board, and at the same time allowing a few of our players to get healthy and kind of get their feet back underneath them. You know, obviously from here on out, it's a Baylor week, all getting prepared for what is a great challenge for our program. An opportunity to play a 6-1 team coming off their first loss of the year, and a team that you know, they've built a nice program. Coach Bryles has obviously done a very good job down there. You know, if you look at where they're at this year, you know, climbed as high as number 4 before that loss. But on offense, they are leading the Big 12 in scoring offense, total offense, rushing offense, pass efficiency, first downs, name it. They lead the Big 12 in a lot of offensive categories. So, obviously, you know, a combination of really good players, a really good scheme. And, you know, Art Bryles has always been an innovative and creative guy when it comes to offense, and that continues. And then on the other side of that, on defense, to combine with that, you know, they lead the Big 12 in total defense as well, you know, coming in second with a rush and second with pass defense. So Phil Bennett, another well-respected defensive coach, you know, has done a nice job with their defense, and they're a very disruptive group. You know, in all, you got a well-coached team, you know, with a good plan and good players, and you know, respect to Baylor. So, you know, obviously it's the kind of game that you know, our players, we tell them all the time, your Big 12 football players is the kind of game that you came to Kansas to play in. And so we're excited and looking forward to a good week getting ready for them.
When you're facing a team like Baylor, they're obviously the offensive machine that they are, but do you focus on trying to slow that down, or do you focus on your offense trying to keep up, or a mixture of the two, or, I mean, what's the emphasis there?
You know, it's like, it's our emphasis every time we talk about it. You know, as a defense, you go out and you get a 3-and-out. You get stops. That's what you do on defense. On offense, you go out and you try to score. You get first downs. You move the chain and go. Now, obviously, with a team like this, you know, you look at, you know, the TCU game where both teams were going tempo, and, you know, TCU played 114 snaps of defense in that game. So you always have to be conscious of you know, the clock and managing the game accordingly. You know, and that's one thing that you know, you think of Baylor and you think of an up-tempo offense, but in reality, they're kind of a grinded-out run-it team. They're leading the conference in run percentage attempts and rush yards. So within there, you know, I think you can be a tempo team and control the clock.
How do you – you know, it's easy to see all those stats, and for your guys to maybe get outside of their heads a little bit and think, gosh, that, like you just said, they're this – juggernaut offensively. How do you teach your guys to focus in on just not worrying about the numbers and not worrying about those stats and just, you know, playing your game and trying to figure it out from there?
Well, that, you know, that's what we always emphasize, and that's what we talk about. You know, every game it comes down to, you know, individual battles. It's obviously the greatest team game in the world, but every play comes down to winning a personal battle. If you're a corner, you got to win your battle against the wideout. If you're a D tackle, you're the nose, you got to win your battle against the center. And just what we, you know, talk about in our program all the time. What is 6 inches in front of your face each and every day? And that's just a constant approach. And, you know, and you can't worry about everything. You know, if I'm Tadarian Johnson, I worry about my gap and beating my center. The rest of it, guys take care of it. And so, you know, you just in football, you simplify and you put it down into things that the kids know that they can control.
The more you see what Baylor's done in the last few years, is it easier to game plan against it, or do they change things up enough year after year to where it's not as easy?
No, it's not as easy. You know, they do. They stay. You know, they keep adding things to it, you know, and they're always, you know, kind of looking for new ways to push the envelope offensively. You know, what they've been able to do there is recruit some really good players. You know, they've been fortunate to get some guys to head that way that, you know, give them a chance to run their scheme effectively. You know, a lot of people have great ideas and, you know, you don't want the players to go out there like they have. So, you know, I don't think it doesn't really ever get any easier against them. And, you know, they know what they're doing.
Cummins throwing the ball a little bit better than Montel did, but does that give defenses something to think about yet, or are they still loading up?
No, I would think so. You know, I mean, I think it, you know, in this conference, as much as people talk about the scoring and all that, it still comes down to stopping the run. And so until you prove that you can consistently throw the ball downfield and complete passes downfield, that's what teams will do. And until you force them out of it, that's what you're going to get each and every week. So, you know, I think with his ability to complete some of the deeper shots and hit a few of those the last few weeks, it has helped.
Texas held Baylor to 28, and West Virginia obviously held them to 27. You've played both of those teams. Does that help at all in terms of just, you know, okay, this team that we've already seen or that team that we've already seen had some success?
Yeah, you know, both of those teams did, and they both kind of had a similar, you know, game plan against them. You know, it was a plan that fit both of their personnel groupings well, and their kids went out and executed it well and played Baylor tight. You know, at the same time, Baylor has, you know, if you're on their end of things and you're talking about those two games, there were quite a few plays that were inches away from, you know, being different plays.
What's the biggest challenge maybe for the defense, not so much during plays, but in between plays when Baylor's in such a hurry to basically run back to the line of scrimmage and then get another play off?
Yeah, the tempo, you know, is something that has, you know, taken over this league and been a big part of it. You know, the challenge is always, you know, what we talk about, you have to play with urgency and you have to match their urgency. You know, I mean, bottom line is their players have to get back to the line of scrimmage as well to run the next play. And if their players are doing it quickly enough, you know, you have to match their urgency and their tempo. And you know, I think we've developed a system that we get our, you know, the tempo stuff hasn't really been an issue for us.
River situation where the other team's offense can maybe speed your offense up? Did you have to guard against that so that things just don't start snowballing and you get ahead where you really want your team to be?
Yeah, there's no doubt. I think, you know, each side of the ball, you have to go in with your plan and execute your plan and be smart with, you know, what you do on your side of the ball.
Rodriguez Coleman had a good spring. Is it still possible he can help you this year?
Oh, yeah. You know, Rod's, you know, been through some things up and down here and there, but, you know, he's back in the mix, and we'll see him on the field.
You talked about getting healthy a little bit, getting some rest during the bye week. Does that include mental rest? I mean, was it good for those guys to have a week off mentally from worrying too much about game plan or anything like that?
I think so. I think it's, you know, you hit midpoint of the season and, you know, everyone gets a little bit tired of each other, you know, at times. So I think it's good to, you know, for them to get away from us as coaches and for, you know, be honest, kind of good for us to get away from them a little bit. You know, you end up spending a lot of time together in this business and, you know, like anything, it's a competitive, intense thing. And sometimes to just take a deep breath and come back, I think is really a positive.
Going in pretty healthy for this week, then?
Yeah, we've maintained pretty good health all year.
Clint, when you run a system like Baylor does, and you lose key guys like they have over the years, and just keep plugging guys in, is it easier when that system stays the same to keep doing that?
Well, I think it is, you know, and they know what exactly they want each position to do and what that criteria for each position is, and they recruit well to it. You know, they've done a nice job of, you know, identifying what they want from each position. You know, their wide outs are, you know, for the most part, guys who can really run. And that's what they do, and that's what they keep going and getting. And, you know, so I think they've, you know, they've identified their target for each spot. You know, they've been a 4-3 quarters team on defense since Phil's gotten there. And so, you know, they know they're going to get some defensive ends that can rush the QB, get home with four, and a challenge on the back end with athletic DBs. And so, they, you know, it has. And when you play a system, you stay in a system for a while and you recruit to that system and you know exactly what you want, it helps across the board. And then those kids, you know, get familiar with it. And, you know, you talk about guys who have heard the same exact defensive call or offensive call for 4 or 5 years, you know, it becomes second nature to them.
You said they keep adding to this thing, which makes it difficult to, you know, continue the game plan. But how about Petty? Does he change? Has he changed a lot throughout his development? I mean, specifically this year to last year?
I think he has. I have a understand, like, just watching Petty play, and if you just step back and look at it, there's some kid things that the kid does that you really have to admire that are impressive. I mean, there's some reads that he makes. There's other defenses in this conference who are trying to make things difficult for him, and they're things, they're throwing the box off, they're rotating safeties, and his ability to pick it up and throw it to the right spot on all the time, I mean, and it's happening on the fly. He has a great understanding of their system. He's an accurate thrower. Obviously, he's a smart kid that can make quick decisions, and he's one of the more impressive guys we've had in the league for a while.
Without getting inside his head, you don't know what he's seeing that's making him deliver those in the right spot. But do you think it's that, the system and just his comfort back there?
It is. You know, obviously a ton of reps at it, and they continue to do it. And he understands his reads. He understands, you know, he understands what they're trying to get done. It's really pretty impressive what they do.
Clint, you guys have got yourself to a lot of third and one and twos, fourth and one and twos, haven't been able to convert. Have you been able to pinpoint what's maybe not going right in those situations?
Well, you know, earlier in the we talked about up front being able to be physical and finish off blocks. You know, a lot of those times you're talking about, can you knock a guy back enough just to get a crease? And we unfortunately haven't been able to do that. And that's been an emphasis and something we've talked about, you know, for a couple weeks now, that up front being able to get some push.
You've talked to so much about being physical and being a physical football team. Is that why it's an emphasis? Is because that's kind of the football team you want to become?
That's you know, I think we did answer that question about why being tough and being physical is important. And, you know, that's one of them situations that, you know, 1 yard, you'd like to think that your team's going to be physical enough to knock someone back enough to get that.
This might be a good question for John, too, but Michael seems like he has a pretty good connection with the tight ends, Jermaine and Ben a little bit too. Is it something that just he's comfortable with those throws, or what do you see there?
Well, you know, I think it is. You know, sometimes guys get a confidence factor and understanding that, you know, how, you know, guys are going to play, but what, you know, they've targeted to do with Jermaine. You know, Jermaine's a talented young man and a guy that, you know, can make some plays for us in a lot of different ways. You know, you take he's a played inline tight end and blocks. He lines up in the backfield, plays basically a fullback, and they flex him out as wide out. So when you have a guy with that versatility, you can, you know, move him around and use him quite a bit. It really helps.
Hey, Glenn, a lot of teams self-scout during bye weeks. I just wonder, with your defense, what's a couple of things that you really like that you guys have done so far, and what's something that maybe you hope you guys can do better?
Yeah, there's no doubt. You run all those reports during this week and do it. You know, obviously we need to get we've been good on first down. You know, we've been able to, you know, hold teams to less than 3 yards on first down. That's been good. Haven't been as good in the coverage in the red zone. You know, we've given up some red zone passes down there. So there were a few things that came up and through there that, you know, we've hopefully addressed.
How big was the bye week for Michael? I mean, your offense is obviously still a work in progress a little bit, trying to make that transition and keep improving. Was that good for him to just have some time to kind of breathe?
I think so. You know, I think he's, you know, gotten in there a couple weeks now, and he's truly settled in as the QB that's running the offense right now. You know, you see him kind of every day. His leadership steps up a little bit more. You know, he seems to have a little bit better command of everything he's doing. You know, decisions get quicker, everything gets faster. You know, when you know, kind of like everything, the more you rep it, and the more you do it, the better you get. And hopefully Mike, you know, he's a competitive kid. He's proven that he's a competitive guy. He's you know, been through some ups and downs in the program and just kept, you know, kept going and going and going. And so he's a tough, mentally tough guy. And, you know, he's into it.
Any other questions?
All right. Thank you.